Hello everyone, welcome back. Just got MXGP, it came out today. And quite possibly could be the best MX game I've ever played. So, let me tell you why. Let's get into it. You see, options menu, just the main menu has many options to choose from. Instant race, regular race. A Grand Prix lets you choose any of the tracks. It's pretty much a one-weekend event. Championship, get to do every track in your order. You can pick and choose what tracks you want to do. Career, it's just, we'll get to that. We'll get to that. Time Attack, they set up this system with their leaderboards from their game, and it allows you to connect to their servers and do time attacks and race against everyone that owns this game, so that's pretty cool. Multiplayer, self-explanatory, but I have yet to do it. I really can't wait, though. I really want to get into the multiplayer. My MXGP, you get to make your own rider. Right now, mine's pretty stock. I'm not far into the game. Allows you to put in all your personal data you want to put in. Appearance, kind of helmet you want, color of your gear, number, style you want to have, and you get to pick a manager. It's kind of funky that way, but no worries, it's all good. Check your stats, all the media you get through the career, and here's the options. Controls, you have a joypad and keyboard, and every button is able to be remapped, so that's really cool to me. If you have a controller or an Xbox controller, I recommend it. It makes the game a whole lot more fun. Alright, so let's get into career. The track I'm currently at. I think it's gonna load me into the race, yeah. So let's see if I can exit the race. Well, I guess it's gonna shove me right into it, so I'm gonna show you the race, and then I'll show you what the main menu for the career looks like. You got your track, you can go ride, you get 35 minutes, that's awesome. You don't have to do the whole 35 minutes, you can go and end it when you want, skip to the next event, but having that 35 minutes is pretty cool. See, you can see the session. See, I could skip it if I want, go straight to qualifying, no practice, or skip to the races even. Coolest part of the game right here, setup. All the things you can do. So we got the preload, spring stiffness, compression dampening, and rebound dampening. And all these matter when you're riding the game, so they can be crucial to getting first on the hardest difficulty or getting second. Gears, you get three choices, high, medium, low. Brakes, there's two choices, so basically stiffer brakes, brake harder, more responsive, and then just do the kind of easier so you don't just go endoing over a corner. And then the data you can load in. I got two setups right now that I could load, but I don't know the track, so I don't know what it's going to need, so because I've never been on it. So we're going to get to it. See what this track needs. Throw a big whip. Over jump a little bit. Cool little chicane. I think the setup right now it's on. Stock setup is alright. The first track I rode on, it was extremely sandy. Oh, that was not good. Yeah, so the first track I rode on was extremely sandy, and it required low gearing. I just couldn't get any power through it. Yeah, all the tracks are extremely diverse. That's really cool. You saw me go over the jump way too fast, and I've never ridden this track before. So I'm kind of guessing as I go here. it's very crucial you put your practice in and get a good feel for the bike and the setup, so you have the right setup going to practice, because if you waste your whole practice trying to get the right setup, you might not put a good lap down. I jumped that one too long, cased on that one. Came up short there, pulled to the inside here. And I'm not catching that guy ahead of me, so I'm putting two good laps in right now. Seems like a track you gotta choke up a lot on, so you might be better to run the stiffer brakes, so I can make sure I get that heavy braking on. Choked up a little there. Didn't seem like it was enough. Pulled the third fastest lap, so that's pretty good, saying it's on the hardest difficulty. Gameplay right now is absolutely phenomenal, though. Oh, getting into the rider. Ooh, shut him down. It was a little dirty, but racing's racing, right? See if I can put the fastest time down. I really enjoy this game. It's far different from the MX series that I played, and and if you've ever played the FIM game, it's not even close to being that game. It's far more better. It's completely realistic in cases of how the bike handles, how it's going to react in a rut, or there's nothing arcadey about it, so I think that's why I really enjoy it. The atmosphere on this game is really cool. The racing is really good. It's very tight. You make one mistake, they're on you. Hard to get a whole shot, not easy. Game's very challenging, and it feels more rewarding when it's challenging like that. It feels definitely more rewarding getting that win. So right now it's $30 on Steam. And that, for a full release game, right out of the factory, this is just phenomenal for $30. My motocross games back in the day, then they were $60, just a lot more. You wouldn't get something like this. So this is really great. I'm gonna pull into the pits. I think the bike setup is good. It's one thing that I'd like to change would be the brakes. Maybe stiffen them a little bit. More responsive is what I mean. Put a good qualifying lap in. And one of the many bugs of this game, well, not many, but this is very, there's been two bugs I've had, this being the most prominent one. This guy, he likes to work on air. There's no bike there, and he sits there, and he works his little butt off on it, so, but that's fine. Doesn't affect the game in any way. See me throwing whips. Both sticks to one side of your choice will do a whip. Hold it longer, bigger the whip. Just barely touch it, he'll do more of a scrub. So that's good. So I'll show you here, like that. Scrubs it a little bit more. Changing those brakes out was a really good idea. Stop on a dime. Oh, that was a good pass. Not too dirty like I usually am in the past. Pull a good qualifying lap time here and we'll go straight in the race so you can see some of the action I'm talking about. I'll switch here to helmet cam. Let you guys get a feel to see how it is. Helmet cam, it's just really cool. I think it did a really good job on it. It just feels right. Being able to see your guy in the shadow doing whips and stuff is really cool. And it's not that I can still feel the bike very well, so it's not like I don't know what I'm doing, and I definitely can feel how the bike's handling, so that's really good. So I posted the top qualifying time, and we're going to go straight into the race here. Into race one. First gate pick, got the best lap. Always on the inside, can never go wrong with being on the inside. Just leaves you can always choke up if you ever have a bad start. One thing I think this game could have done better on is a more random start, so I didn't know when it was gonna drop, or the gate was gonna drop. See, almost got taken out there, that was no good. Oh, too hot into that corner. Took me and the guy out. I am riding on the hardest difficulty with all the assists off. So... you won't have to worry about difficulty this hard if your skills on motocross games aren't that good, because I think they did very well scaling the difficulty, because it definitely took me a little while to get to the top difficulty of this game, because it's unlike any motocross game I've ever played, so that in itself was great, having a challenge. And it gives you live feeds of what people are doing in the bottom left corner. Are they crashing, or if someone's coming up on you, you're starting to catch up. Who's passing who? I think the HUD is very, very done well. It's clean. It doesn't get in the way. It tells you everything you need to know. Like, they're right on me. 2 seconds isn't much in this game. One bad crash and I'm probably going to be in third, so I got to make sure I keep it clean. Oh, that was not good. Tried keeping it pinned down, did not turn out well. definitely is better not to crash, because you crash and start you in neutral. I don't really like that. I guess it's because I'm in manual mode, so start you in neutral and it's a really slow start. So it's definitely better to go for a save than crash altogether. Starting to open up a gap here. This track's been one of the easier tracks of the championship. I don't usually pull away like this. My first race, I think, was the hardest. It was a sand track. I came away with a third overall. It's definitely not easy. Crashing was a lot more prominent. So this track, I enjoy it. Oh, I tried choke up a little bit. Did not work. I think they're right on me. I have a feeling. I'm surprised I didn't get past. That was not smart. Oh, that was a bad start. You see, it starts you in neutral. Not good. He must have been making mistakes too. We'll see how far behind in that split time. 2 seconds, yeah. Must have made some mistakes. I think the multiplayer will be great though. The competitiveness of it definitely is gonna test your skills. I imagine the person who doesn't crash on multiplayer will be the person who wins. Overall, the game is phenomenal. It really is for a $30 buy. I bought it on the spot. I mean, I knew the game, what it was, and when it was coming out. But was no hesitation, and I'm very happy with this buy. It is really great. One of the better PC ported titles I've had. Doesn't take much to run the game either. Acquiring system specs and all. Gives you a fairly open range of graphics you can choose from. Anti-aliasing. Resolution, windowed mode, all that. And there's the win. So, if you're thinking about buying this game, highly recommend it. The game is great. And other than that, I just hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it informed you of it. And thanks for watching. Have a good day.